this evening, Father, by our very own. That was the Glenda. So excited about the anointing on her life. Listen, today will be her initial sermon. We don't do trial sermons. We're not on trial. And when a person is on trial, that means man judge whether or not you've been called. But I'm so glad I didn't get my caller from man. I got it from God. And so today is the day that we set aside to allow her publicly to do what she's been doing in private. Years ago, she came to the church quiet. Behind the scene, God has elevated her and used her. All over the church, you got her hands and everything. Not concerned about preaching, she want to serve. She want to serve. What can I do to help? So I thank God for the anointing on her life. Have written plenty of plays for the youth department. To really galvanize the youth, amen, to speak life to the youth. And that's why they love her so much. She's been very, very patient with them and working in the back with the media, the sounds, and checking the mics. Being our intercessor, praying. Yes. Thank God for our prayers. So you went on from writing plays, now you're writing sermons. So we're glad to have her. I'm going to introduce her. Then after I introduce her, I think we have a dance from the youth department. Stretch your hands towards her. Repeat after me. Minister Glenda. You better preach this word.
You better preach this word.
Minister Glenda.
You
better teach this word.
Minister
Glenda.
You better explain
this
word.
Amen. After the dance team come, they may come now. The next voice you will hear is our very own Minister Glenda Hinton.
Standing here, all that I am is because. just not enough words. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Give it all to God for this day. Thank you, God, for the man and the woman of God of this house. Apostle and Lady Marge, I love y'all. I appreciate you so much. To the sister pastor and Minister Powell, I thank God for you. Thank you for everything that you help me with, and I appreciate y'all so, so very much. It's just not enough words. Rhema Word Ministry. Rhema Word Ministry. Let's pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. This is you, God, it's not me. I will be the vessel that you use. I will do whatever you need me to do in this hour. All of you, and none whatsoever of me. I give you praises, and I give you glory for everything that you're about to do. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. Do you all know that in Proverbs, that Proverbs is a book of instructions? It is a book of understanding. It's a book of wisdom from God, our Father. How many of you know that we need wisdom? We need understanding. We need instructions to be able to have God's DNA. So today, if you will stand for the reading of the word, we're going to come out of Proverbs. And we're going to get some advice from him. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let's turn to Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and verse 6. It should be a very familiar scripture to us. Very familiar scripture. That's Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. And this is his advice. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart. Lean not on thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. If I may give a subject today, my subject is my journey is not over yet. My journey is really just beginning. So I want you to look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor your journey is not over yet. Now look at the other side and tell your neighbor, your journey is not over yet. When we think about journey, or when we research our journey, it's a traveling from one stage to another. You're going to travel from one place to the to another. And then when we think about, I'm sorry, yes, have a seat, sit down. When we go back and we look at the word path, path is the way of life. So that means that if you go back to Proverbs 3 and 6, it said, in all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct your way of life. So how many want God to direct your way of life? We need him to direct our way of life. Now there's many paths on this journey that you could take, but is it the right one? Are you taking the right journey? Are you doing the right thing? Are you taking God's journey, or are you taking Satan's journey? Now we got to move out of that journey with Satan, and we got to move over here, and we got to travel from one stage to another to get to God. One of the things that we got to do, we got to trust him. The Bible just told us that we must trust the Lord with all thine heart, not with your money, not with your car, not with your house, not with your children, not with your party time, not with your food. None of that. It said, trust the Lord with all thy heart. Lean not on thy own understanding. So we're going to talk about Elijah. If you have read in 1 Kings, it talks about Elijah and how Elijah himself went on a day's journey into the wilderness. Now, Elijah went in this cave. He was trying to hide. Now, I'm going to tell you a little bit about the story, but you're going to have to read majority of it on your own. But I'm letting you know that it's in 1 Kings. In 1 Kings, Elijah ran from Jezebel. He ran from Jezebel because he was on a journey. He was on his journey. That means if he ran from Jezebel, he stepped off of his journey when he ran in the cave. And when he ran in the cave, now God did take care of him. The angels fed him and everything. But he still got off track. When he got off a track, he even left his servant. He was so afraid. He left him in the city and he went and got in the cave. Okay? So when he went and got in the cave, God came to him and said, Elijah, what you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing in the cave? Elijah said, what happened was, Jezebel, you know, I was afraid of her, so I didn't want nobody to see me, so I even just left the servant, and I decided to come and just hide in the cave. And hiding in the cave, then, you know, your people, God, I'm talking about your people, God, they didn't want to listen to me. They were going to kill me, too, so I ran. Isn't that how sometimes we do? We be afraid of what we supposed to be doing. We get afraid because there's a distraction. There's someone telling us that we can't do it, or they're giving us negative vibes, or they telling us negative stuff. And so instead of us staying on the road to our journey, we get off track. And he got off of track. He started blaming God. Not only did he blame God, he was blaming others. Isn't that how we do sometimes? We blame others for our mishap, our mistake, or our troubles, or our problems. We blame other people. He kept making excuses. Okay, what happened was, okay, that was an excuse. What happened was, Jezebel is, what happened was, so he kept making excuses. Do you know it is predestined for you to be on this right pathway? All right. It's predestined for you to be on the right roadway. Okay. All right. It's predestined for you to be on the right trailway to your destination. My purpose today is to advise you to trust God on this journey of life and to let you know this is the best decision that I have made in my life. Can I tell you the journey is not for me, it's for somebody else. The journey is not for you. You just gotta stay on it. It's not for you, but it's for somebody that's watching you. Someone that's paying attention to you, and you don't even know they're watching you. You don't even know they see everything, because when someone watching you, they see you with the natural eye. They may not know how to deal with the spiritual eye, but they watching you with their natural eye. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? What are you going to, how are you going to present yourself on this journey? It's for the ones that sees the road that I travel. You know, my grandbaby, I had him ever since, you know, I keep him ever since he was a preemie. And I watched him from a preemie all the way to 2 years old. And an infant baby journey starts with their parents, and their parents' trail. All right. It starts with their parents' path. Come on. They depend on the parents to get from one stage to the other to get to their next destination in life. In the midst of their journey, the baby may encounter storms as a baby. One of the storms that the baby encounter is the colic. I'm sure if you're a mother or a father, you have heard of the colic. Now, it tells me when I was reading on the colic that a baby may get the colic and cry at a continuous time every day. Usually it's from 6:30 to midnight. Now, when the baby is crying, there's another storm that they go through, is diaper rash. When they have diaper rash, you have to apply a certain ointment on the baby to keep the baby soothed. Now, it's the same way with us. When we go through different things, God wants us to cry to him. He wants us to come to him so he can apply the ointment to our body. So that we can be more like him. Now, the colic doesn't last long, neither does the diaper rash. Guess what? That's the same thing when we go through storms. It doesn't last long. So why can't we get back on track, get back on that journey that God has us on, so we can continue the work of the Lord? Now, another thing that the child does, when a child starts to walk, he or she depends on their parents to hold their hand as they make steps, because the baby trusts their parents with all of their heart. We should trust in the Lord with all our heart. Then there's another thing that the children do, and that is the hard-headedness. Don't touch that stove. The heater is hot. It's gonna burn. Let me say it again. Don't touch that stove. It's gonna burn. Don't touch that heater. It's gonna burn. Don't touch it. What happens? They touch it anyway. Do not lean on your own understanding. Can
Curious George, Curious George. I just want to see how I feel. I want to know why God don't want me to go that way. I want to know why he told me to go to the right and I decided to go to the left. Oh, God. Then I'm crying. Oh, you told me not to do that. You told me not to go that way. But because I was curious and I started leaning on my own understanding, I had to try it. There's another one. One more. When children go through a storm, they fall and hurt themselves. That child get up and try it again because they are on a journey. No matter how much it may hurt, they jump back on the path of growth. I'll never forget, my grandbaby came in the house one day, and I asked my son, I said, what happened to his nose? It was all stretched up, and the lip was all stretched up, and I said, Richard, what happened to him? He said, well, he was running, and he fell. And I said, he fell. He said, no, we asked him, did he want to go back in the house, or what, was he through playing? And he said, no, and he just fell. Start back running. Oh. So when we fall and we come short, we got to jump back up. And we got to get back to God as quick as possible. Because when a child falls and hurt themselves, they get back up. And they start doing it again. I'm going to try this again. So why can't we continue to do the same thing? Can we do the same thing on our journey? We have to go to God like little children. We have to trust God like a baby trusts his mother to get to their journey and growth. So we need to trust God so we can get to our journey that God promised us. Sometimes on our journey, we may encounter storms. Okay, adults, here we go. Sometimes when we encounter storms, the storms could be problems on our job. It could be at home. It could be our children, our wife, our husband, or it could be drugs. The bills are due. The car just stalled. The doctor just called. My question is, what are you going to do? Do I stop and go back to where I started? Or do I continue my journey because I need to get to my destination? Let me repeat that again. Let me ask you that question again. Do I stop and go back to where I started? Or do I continue my journey because I need to get to my destination? Now, you got to know what your destination is. You got to know what it is. When you are on the right road, Satan attacks goes to a different level. It goes to a different level. You trying to get out the house to go to work. The kids acting up. You trying to go to work and be peaceful. The people acting up. You trying your best to cook a good meal. The husband acting up. You trying to fix the car outside and the wife acting up. There's always something in the pudding when you're trying to get to your destination. But you gotta continue going, you gotta continue going, you gotta continue running, walking, whatever you need to do to stay on your destination, God. There were times on my journey that I did not know how to handle things because I was trying to do it my way, not God's way. Even in the process of being neglected or abused, when I was let down, I still was trying to do things my way. When I was told I wouldn't be anything, when I was laughed at, and when I was disliked, I had to gird up. And I had to realize that God is my provider, not them. God is the only one I must put my trust in. So God is the only one that y'all must put your trust in. Sometimes I just want to give up or give in because I can't see what's in front of me. Let's talk about the woman with the issue of blood. She stayed in the house because of the way the people treated her. She stayed isolated. She did not come out. But because she wanted to be healed, she wanted to be set free, she wanted to be delivered, she wanted to be restored, she ran out that house to touch the hem of Jesus' garment. Vianna, Vianna. Is Vianna here? She's not here? One of the things that the woman with the issue of blood, the reason why that she could not look on the side of her, she couldn't look the left or the right. She had to keep her eyes on Jesus.
Teach us.
Only thing that she could see was that hem. Now there's two hems in this story. There's H-I-M and there's H-E-M. So she kept her eyes. I just want you to walk, okay? I just want you to walk. She kept her eyes on his hem because she had to get to it, because that's the only way that she could be delivered and set free. Turn around, go back that way and go up the stairs. She had to be delivered. She said, I can't see no distraction. The people done talked about me. They done put me down. They don't know what I'm going through. But I just got to keep my eyes on Jesus and his hem. Because that's what's going to deliver me. Because my journey is not over yet. Look at your neighbor again and say, my journey's not over yet. Oh God, thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Oh Jesus. I'm tired of going through the same thing. Hallelujah, Jesus. I keep looking back at my past like Lot's wife, thinking that the sin and the things of the world is better than what God promised me. But because God is our Savior, we can get up and we can get on the right track. But you have a choice. You have a choice, like Jesus had a choice. On Jesus' journey, he didn't stop. No matter what happened, when he was hung and nailed to the cross, remember, he's on his journey. He could have said no, but because his journey to save our soul, he stayed on the cross. He stayed up there for me and for you. We have to trust God. We have to trust him. Get help if you don't understand. Leaning on your own understanding can ruin your life. Ask the Pharisees. My journey is not over yet. I am not going back on the road to my past. God didn't say we would not go through. He didn't tell us that the road won't get bumpy. We have to trust him knowing that he got us if we just stand on his promises. We have to speak life on our journey. Speak life. I am going to keep going. If my journey is to go to the right or go to the left, I will continue my destination. My transformation is connected to the road that I travel. Did you know that your transformation is connected to the road that you travel? God said in his word that he would lead and guide you. He would direct you. He would direct your path. He would direct us to our destination. Your journey is not based on who get there first. It's based on your walk with God and your endurance. On this journey, we need each other. On this path of righteousness, we need each other. God's word said he would direct our path. Am I closing?
Take it to your turn.
We need to not give up on our journey. Keep going. Because when you make one step, God makes two. Don't think because you got off the roll of endurance that it's over, because my God said it's not over. It is not my journey and your journey is not over yet. No, it's not over. Shake off the dust and get back on the path to your destination. Will continue to be your guide and your compass to your destination, but you got to trust him. He is a God that doesn't lie. He won't turn his back on you if you believe him. Give him all your troubles. He can take care of them better than we can. So God is still working on us so that we may get to the promised land. Remember, your journey is not over yet. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Don't lean on your own understanding. In all thy ways, acknowledge God. And he shall direct each and everybody's path. Amen. Thank you all.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bounce around that chair. If you would sit in this chair, you can bounce around that chair.
Your official license. ordination. This is to certify Linda Henry. The bearer hereof has been ordained on this 23rd day of October in the year of our Lord, 2022. It is officially recognized as and has all rights and privileges to perform all duties of a minister.
Words of encouragement by our own Pastor Powell. To you all, Minister Linda Henry.